When I was working in a hospital back in Singapore, I saw that there was a lot of things that I could improve, but so little time that I could do the research on. I thought, you know, I'm just gonna do research full time. I'll do a PhD. And that's how it all started. Hi, my name is Chad, and I'm in the third year of my PhD. In Singapore, there's no degree that you can pursue if you want to be a dietitian. So my lecturers say that if you want to do dietetics, you have to go to Flinders. We get a lot of hands-on experience doing the course. It's not just reading off a slide. Even in the classrooms, we were taught case studies. So a lot of focus is being put in the practical aspects of clinical dietetics, which that's the difference between my diploma and pursuing a degree that ultimately gets me accredited as a dietitian. What inspired me to do my PhD project is that we have a healthcare system that takes care of us from the day we were born to the day we die. So my project is about empowering older adults to self-care with nutrition and exercise. I see them every day while they're admitted in the hospital. And then when they get home, I visit them to give them the best chance of staying at home. Looking at the people that I have delivered the intervention to, most of them have told me that they feel stronger, better, and faster.
I met Chad. I was in Flinders Hospital, and Chad come and visit me, and he asked me would I go in this program, and I said, okay, I'll do it if it helps for people to learn about exercise, which to me is very important.
When I see Barbara, I feel like she's my auntie. She came in to the project thinking that she's helping me, and then later on she found out that actually there's so much that she could learn.
He does a very good job. He's very personable. It's very easy to get on with, and that's important.
I'm very, very thankful to be able to see participants like Barbara. I would say that this has been the best decision I've made, because sitting in my office in Singapore, I asked myself if I'll be doing this for the rest of my life, and the answer was no, so I applied for Flinders. I don't ever want to retire. I want to do research and teach for as long as I can walk.